No one in the dark.
And again,
welcome everyone, and I'm going to be doing an investigation from my wall. As you can see, I am using the Kinect, which is a very popular kind of tool to use. You may have seen it on Ghost Adventures and many other paranormal programs. So I'm going to be using that to hopefully capture any anomalies in the room. Earlier on I captured some kind of skeleton by the wall and kept coming and going, but at the moment it's not showing itself, so hopefully it might come back. I'm also using some trigger objects on the table. As you can see, I have three pyramids on the table which you can rotate, and three balls which you can see my dad's is lighting up now. I'm also going to be using a thermal detector which can light up, and I'm just going to show you where I've been. This will give off light changes, you know, you can put your hand across it and it will go to red or warm. If it's a warm temperature it will be red. Blue will be cold temperature, and green is neutral. I'm just going to point it towards the mirror. You can see red. Green is neutral. And sometimes spirits can alter the temperature of this, so it will go to whatever colour the spirit is. If it's a cold spirit, it will go to blue, red to a red, for warm. So yeah, that will keep changing. And also, these are little balls that light up just by touching them. I have one from my auntie, which is my late auntie's pyramid as well there, which can rotate just by turning. I also have my mom's in the middle, which is a ball there, and also a pyramid for my mother, which will also turn. So this one's for my auntie, my mom, and my dad's. My dad's already has been flashing. Sometimes his light always flashes, so my dad's pyramid as well is turning there. They are just pyramids that I've made with a spike, where you place a pyramid on the spike and it will just turn by itself. No motors or anything, just a spike with a pyramid. I've also got a pump here as well. This will generate electromagnetic fields for the spirits to use as energy if they wish to, so they can use that to do whatever they want to do in the room. I've also got a trigger cat as well. This is my auntie's old toy cat. This also triggers by switching on. I've also got another detector up here as well. Just by touch, this will light up. I don't know if you can see that. A trigger object there. I've also got one here. And also flash. So it's quite a few different trigger objects. And one here. You can touch that one as well and it will light up. And switch it off. So ghosts can use all kinds of trigger objects to use right now as well. So there's all different kinds of ways for them to communicate. I'm also going to be using this generator. This is a frequency generator. When I switch that on, it will give off energy from that, and they can use those energy as well. And I've also got a full spectrum camera that I'm going to be using to take pictures, and the K2 meter. You may have seen these as well on TV. Very popular to use. And also the famous ghost box, which has been used on Ghost Adventures and many other programs, so I'm going to be using that as well. And the digital recorder for EVPs. So I'm just going to get straight into it, and then hopefully we will see what we get. As I said before, I can't guarantee things will happen. It all depends, you know, what kind of spirits I have in the room, whether they are friendly or maybe even evil. I've had a few different spirits that have came in through the ghost box, which are friendly. Some are really nasty. I've had a few nasty ones, saying that they wish to kill me or whatever, but nothing has come to that, so obviously I wouldn't be standing here today. As you can see, my dad's light is flashing again, so maybe my dad is in the room at the moment. So I'm going to call out to him if he can hear me, if he can do things in the room. Dad, if you are here, being that you are flashing your light, can you try and develop on the camera? Maybe even show yourself on the K2. Can you develop? Sorry if I got a bit of a sore throat as well. I'm trying to talk. Can you light up your light again, Dad? Just to let me know you're there. Can you make it flash again? Thank you. There we go. Maybe if my mother as well is in the room, I would love to have yours flashing as well now. In the middle, can you flash your light? I know my dad's here. Sometimes in the daytime my mom flashes her light as well. My dad's does it frequently actually. Not very often, but he does it nearly every time I'm in the room with him. Can you flash your light, mom? Or turn your pyramid? Dorothy, if you are in the room, can you make your light flash? Sometimes you may see flashes of light as well going across the screen. Can't guarantee whether they are bugs or whether they are orbs. They could be Barbie orbs as well. And there are quite a few of them over the years where I've seen many of them. And today as well, I've actually, while I was in this room, I noticed that the tap in the kitchen turned itself on again. The hot water tap. I was playing snooker on my table, and then I heard this dripping from the kitchen. Before I didn't hear it, but it just came on, and I had to go in the kitchen and turn it off again. And it's not the first time it's done that, it's done it over many times. And I don't know why it keeps doing it, but I can only assume that it's down to spirits, because I know there's been a lot of cases with people who had the same problems with their taps, especially when they are living in a haunted property, and they usually have the same kind of things happening, even door slamming as well, and things being moved around. Even being touched by spirits as well. I've actually been touched by a spirit. I can't tell whether it was my relatives or I don't know, because I just felt a touch on my shoulder. And there we go again, my dad's light flashing again. And he's letting me know he's here. Please, Dad, if you are in the room, can you make this change to red? I want you to do that. Make it change to red by the door. So you may see my body on the actual K2. You see me as a skeleton, or I don't know what you can see on camera, but yeah, my dad is making this light flash. Every time I talk about my dad's light flashes, as you can see again, I haven't even touched it, so I know he is around. Okay, I'm gonna I'm just going to do a few readings actually, okay, to see if I can get any readings from this. Can you make this K2 light up there as well? Need a lamp, make it flash. Very interesting that it's not flashing the K2. Weird. Sometimes it flashes around here. What do I? And look at me there. So he's letting me know he's around tonight. This old chair as well, this chair belongs to my auntie, so it's I think about 50 years old, maybe more, and my brother saw my mum sitting in this chair when she died in 2012, and she was actually watching us at the time. On Christmas time, drinking, and she was sitting in that chair watching us from over there. She was over here, my dad was sitting here, my mom was there, and my brother was staring right at them. I was sitting there next to him, and it freaked him out because they was watching me and my brother drinking. And he was staring at us like as if we were doing something wrong. Maybe they didn't like us drinking. Because sometimes your spirits can let you know that it's bad. Whatever you do, they will let you know. Sometimes I feel cold spots as well in the room. The other day I was over in that corner and I don't know why, but I felt really cold, like a cold blast of air, and I was feeling static as well, which is very common for spirits in the room. Okay, I didn't get any readings, so next thing I'm going to do is take some pictures, so you may see a few flashes on the camera, and hopefully we may capture a few spirits on the actual photos. So there you go. I'm going to take multiple pictures as well, so you can make sure that we capture something. See the light flashing in the corner as well, there is a sensor. So it does light up in the dark when you flash the camera in there. It's very sensitive. So it's nothing to do with the ghost. My mom's is flashing there in the middle. It's nice to know. Hello mom, if you're in the room. It actually captures a few anomalies as well in the mirror over the years, sometimes faces, weird pictures as well. I don't know what to call them, but especially in the little mirror, captured a soldier who was all dressed up in the army uniform, and completely out as well. And I thought it was my dad because I know my dad used to dress up as an army soldier. So I always thought it might have been him. Just letting me know. I'm just going to take some more pictures. In this room, can you try and develop on that take your picture? Show yourself as a fully formed figure, whichever you want to be, a ghost, maybe even my mom and dad. Do you have anything you wish? Just to know if you are in the room. Maybe if you can make a noise. Make a bang. Sorry, that's me making a... Sometimes I set things off as well, so I got careful. I'm just trying to see if I can get some It's funny as well, when I'm using this camera I can actually see the K2 sensors. Like little dots all over the camera. So I'm actually capturing them as well. The actual sensor. So it makes it work. I don't know where I got it in there, but it looks like a mist. Misty face or something. I don't know what it is. And again. I do capture some weird stuff in the mirror. Which is why I use mirrors, because they reckon it's the other side of a doorway to the other side. Okay. Is there any spirits here now? Can you just try and develop right in front of me? To know if you are really here. Give me a sign. My mom and dad splashing up on my mother. When I first done this, I was a bit kind of skeptical about it all. I felt, why am I doing it? Why? And then, when I caught my first few orbs on the cameras, and especially on the video, I felt, you know, more intrigued. And I just wanted to do more and more to capture, you know, try and capture everything I can. just put it out there to people, see what they think, whether it's a ghost or whether it's just mold or their dust, cobweb, whatever. I always leave it up to you. But I always feel a bit kind of, you know, undecided about things when I see and when I captured. Okay, I'm just going to turn on the generator. Hopefully you will capture feelings with this as well. So I will hear the beeps and then I will switch on. It will stay on for about 7 minutes and then it will shut down again. You may see things, you may not. Can't believe it's already nearly off now. I've gone nearly. So quiet on my channel as well. Honey coffee. He's with me now. I believe the camera's running overnight, so. And, the ghost box is probably the most popular thing that I'm doing. So you will hear a lot of voices on this. Over the years, I captured voices of, I don't know, it was probably like evil voices on here. I heard a few nasty ones which said, die, for me to die. One who said, you dirty bee, call me a dirty bee. Quite a few nasty words I've heard. Nothing physical though has happened to me. Is there any spirits in the room? Can you make a noise? Can you make a tap on the table? You may hear the clock ticking away there. Can you show a face in the mirror? Try and develop. Sometimes I can't guarantee that you will see things or hear things, you mean. That's why I do this, because I know we can't get everything done in one night. It could take many, many nights before we capture something. So that's why I always say that I can't guarantee you will see anything. Or hear anything. Okay, I'm just going to put that spotlight back on again. As you can see, it changes to red. Just by doing that, it changed to red. Right, next thing I'm going to do is the ghost box. hopefully you may hear some voices. I'm going to put it in reverse sweep. It's just eliminating any kind of contamination from anything to do with the radio channel. It's going backwards on the actual frequency, so there's a beauty about this thing actually. Okay, I'll call it any spirits in the room. If you wish to come forward and talk, here's your chance. My name is Michael, and you call out your name. And you call out your name. Can you see me? Do you know my name? Any spirits in the room? Can I call out your name? Is your name Peter? Did I hear Paul? Paul? Is that right? Is there a Paul in the room? Yes or no? Is there a Peter in the room? Can I have a boy? Is my dad in the room? Are you in the room with me, Dad? Just call out your name. Did you make the light flash earlier? I noticed it's not flashing. Can you make it flash again, Dad? So that you know you're there. Thank you. Oh. Just when I said it. Can you say hello, Dad? Hello, I need a very faint hello. Are you happy? Did I hear my voice? You was happy. Aren't you happy now? Can you make your light flash again then? Please, can you do it again? Is my mother here? Can you say hello? Can you say hello? Can you still love me, Mom? Can you still love me? Hello, Jenny. Jenny, are you there? Say hello, Jenny. That was my sister, Rosa, and dog. She was 1 year old when she died. And Jennifer. Are you there, Jennifer? You want to say hello to me as well? Please. Are you all happy? Are you all? Do you all come to visit? Do you all come to see us? Is Trevor there? My sister's late husband, who passed away last year. Are you there, Trevor? Do you want to come? Do you want to leave a message? Please. Do you still love Christine, my sister? There's still other kids as well. Is there any other spirits who wish to come forward and talk? If you have a message for any of us, please come forward. Say hi. So I don't know if it's coming for them.
Let's switch it back on.
No death, making my light flash again. Is there any other spirits here? I just wish to know how many are in the room. The light's gone to blue now. There's a cold spot there. Is there a spirit by the door? Is Dorothy there? Dorothy, are you in the room? Your light up, Dorothy. And the noise. I know my dad's in the room. He always lights, isn't it? Is there any... Is there any evil spirits in the room? Any bad spirits? Didn't quite catch that. Did I hear sure of his? Was it sure his? That means there is bad spirits in the room. Do you hear me all? Okay, we've got to 2:15 already, so 15 minutes to play with, then we'll be finished. I'm gonna do an experiment. I'm gonna whistle and see whether the ghost box and capturing the one whistling back to me. Okay, I'm gonna whistle to any spirits in this room, and I want you to whistle back, please. There you go. Do it again. Can you whistle back to me if I whistle to you on the ghost box? I'm going to whistle in it 3 times. Knocks. Can you knock back on those box? Yeah? Oh my god, it's flashing again. My tickets. Tickets. Can you knock back? Let me try again. 2 knocks. Me a question. What is the question? Okay, I'm going to close the ghost box now because I'm going to move on to the next thing I want to do. About 10 minutes to go in here. Ouch. Does ghosts like to play around? Do they like playing around with people? I always wondered. Do they like playing around with the living? Do you like to hurt people? And you ghost too. You always want to hurt. Why do you want to hurt people? Can't understand. But nothing is alive. You want to do it when you're dead. You go to hell when you die. Do you see God? My dad was waiting at his door when I said that. Amazing. You see God, Dad? Does my mom see God? Yeah? see those when you die. Do you see Jesus? Do you see all the family when you die? All your past relatives? Aren't they all with you? What about your pets? Can you see the dogs and cats? Yeah. So you see everyone. I've always wondered if you actually still breed. Do you still breed after death? Spirits here before I go and then closing. Any other spirits who wish to talk before I go? Last chance. My mom. Just say any word. Dad, you want to say anything? And my auntie. Is there any spirits in there? Can you come forward and show yourself? It'd be nice to see you. Camera's gone. Camera's just gone funny on me then. No way. It's just gone off. There's like two lines. I think my batteries are dying. Okay, I'll have to leave my camera because it's playing up like hell. I don't know whether it's the ghost or what, but okay, just going to do eat the peas, then get out of bed. Okay, now I'm doing EVPs on the 20th of the 3rd, 2019, at 1:56 in the UK time, and I'm going to call it to any spirits in this room who wish to talk. Maybe you have a message. My name is Michael. I just wish to know your name. If you want to call it, please do. Please give your name. Can you make a noise? Make a knock on the table. If my dad is in the room and you make a noise, Dad. Or call out your name. Say hello. Do you like what I'm doing? Do you like what I do? That might not be the best way to communicate. But many people have done it from different ways of communicating with ghosts, using the ghost box. Digital recorder, videos, you name it, we do it. And trying new things as well, even through Ouija boards. And Ouija boards is the last thing I would use if it was the only thing to use to communicate with ghosts. It would be the last thing I would use, because I know they are dangerous. And I've also known a few people who have actually used one. And I've had a few weird experiences with them. I would have never used one. But if they paid me, I would use one. Here's the thing. Spirits here now who wish to leave me a message, whether it's a good message or a bad message. Maybe a message from my brother, my sister, any kind of message. please communicate. Is my mother in the room? That's the generator just going off. I'm going to switch it off actually because I'm not in the zone. And please, if you are here, can you do something on the table? Can you turn one of the lights on? My dad's apparently just turning. Even when you're turning your pyramid down, you don't light your ball up again. And you've been lighting it up all night. Can you do it again? Any other spirits here? Before I go, last chance to communicate. Show an orb in the room. Light, anything? Bang? Make a knock. Okay, gonna stop them calling them. And leave now for tonight. And that concludes the investigation for tonight. And I'm gonna go over everything tomorrow, if not in the next few days. And then I will post whatever I captured on my channel. And I also have my links below chat if you wish to go to them, and you can see all the latest videos and my latest photos and EVPs as well. So I will see you on the next one. Until then,